Welcome everyone to the Fan of a Cloud in the Field. In today's episode, we are going to talk about secure alerts. But before talking about secure alerts, I want to make sure that you remember to subscribe to our playlist under the Microsoft Security Channel, aka link below. Make sure to hit the bell to receive notifications when new videos are uploaded. And if you are already a subscriber, thank you very much. I hope you are enjoying all the new episodes that we are releasing. Going back to the topic for today, secure alerts, secure incidents, data correlation, very exciting things, and no one better than the Microsoft security researcher behind this capability, Daniel Davrayev. Sorry if I make a mistake on your name.
No, but it's perfect.
Thank you very much for being on, my friend.
Thank you for having me, Yuri. It's always a pleasure.
Awesome. Daniel, before we start, can you please give a brief overview about what you do for Microsoft?
Yes. So my main focus in Microsoft, I'm part of the Microsoft Defender for Cloud research team, and I'm working on enhancing the threat protection and specifically the correlation experience and the incidents in Microsoft Defender for Cloud. As we may go through some of the new capabilities, my main focus is on investigating and finding a new security threats behind real-world attacks that happen in the wild, creating detections for them, and trying to build a good incidence correlations for these attacks.
Awesome. That's a very exciting work. And thank you very much for everything you do to improve the overall experience of our alerts. The customers truly appreciate that. Alerts is an area that is very important to Defender for Cloud. And actually, talking about this, we at Defender for Cloud, historically, we always had alerts that were created for different workloads, right? I mean, it's very important that the alerts are very well crafted for specific workloads, the alerts for storage accounts, alerts for key vaults. So we have security researchers working on those analytics and based on the threat landscape for each workload. Now, I understand that we have internal mechanisms to avoid false positive, but can you elaborate more on what we do to allow alert prioritization?
Yes. So alert prioritization is really critical for the SOC teams, especially when it comes to investigating real threats. SOC teams sometimes handle many different alerts on different resources. It's a known issue we call it alert fatigue, and helping them prioritizing what's really important to investigate and remediate between these alerts is critical for us, the security researchers. For that, we have few features such as having severities, but more than that, we are now doing correlations, and we enhanced our correlations to help the SOC to understand better the attack and what happened. As we know that attacks are evolved with time, and they are involve different resources and different TTPs, we try to correlate each attack together. So we might see few alerts that have some shared entities, such as user, IP addresses, resources, correlated together to one incident. This helps the SOC operations team to prioritize the work and investigation and better visualize the threat landscape of the potential threat malicious activity by the attacker.
That's excellent. That's a very good overview of the prioritization process. Following up on that, over the years, SOC analysts, they always express their concern about the number of alerts that they need to triage, which become more challenged when you are trying to do alert correlation. When it comes to alert correlation, as you mentioned, how Defender for Cloud can help and why this is so important?
So, yes, exactly. These concerns are already known to us, and as we get feedbacks from the customers. And Defender for Cloud tries to help here by investigating and doing a lot of threat hunting and getting feedbacks from the customers on real-life attacks that happen in the wild. And based on this research that we have been doing and the threat hunting, we are trying to build those correlations and be very specific on the attack story that behind these correlations. This helps for the SOC operations teams to better understand why these correlations are grouped together. For example, if we are seeing multiple alerts that are part of the same Kubernetes cluster, we can help to address the SOC with why we think these alerts are relevant on which kind of Kubernetes attack it might involve. And this helps saving a lot of time and effort for the SOC to better understand the investigation and where to focus their remediations. They have today in the correlations a specific display name to understand what is the security incident. They have a description that will help them to give more information on what is being correlated and why. And all this information give the SOC better perspective of the threat and help them to faster remediate the investigation effort.
Okay, yeah, that's a good reflection in how Defender for Cloud helps is very important. It saves a lot of time. As a matter of fact, this data correlation is one of the features that we receive very good feedback from customers just because of the time that saves to investigate. Now, there is also a question that comes up very often from customers that know more about this and they think it's cool, but they always ask, okay, so how these alerts are correlated? How Defender for Cloud knows that they are all part of an attack? The
Yeah,
behind the
great.
scenes, right?
Yeah, great, great question. So as I mentioned a bit before, Microsoft Defender for Cloud security researchers are doing a lot of threat hunting operations, and by investigating alerts, we are seeing different techniques, sometimes even new techniques, and we understand the flow of the attack. These understanding, this research help us build these correlations. We know how to group specific alerts together that will represent a specific attack scenario that we have seen in the wild. Moreover, when we see some kind of an incident, of an attack, and we see some new techniques that are being used, we develop new detections that will also be correlated to that specific incident. For example, when it comes to crypto mining attacks, we are seeing many different techniques of creating compute resources that attackers are used for abusing compute for crypto mining activities. And we have created and deployed many new detections, both in Defender for Arm, in DNS, for this specific scenario. And based on this detection, we also created a correlation that will that emphasize the specific incident of a cryptocurrencies attack. It's just a
Awesome.
little behind the scenes work that we are doing to cover new scenarios and threats we are seeing in the wild.
Excellent. Now you mentioned Defender for Arm, Defender for the DNS, which means different plans. So does Secure Incident support all Defender for Cloud plans? In other words, does it look for data correlation across all plans?
Yes, of course. It's really important for the SOC operations team to have the complete visualize of the landscapes. As we know, attacks involves in many times different resources. It could involve storage, it could involve SQL, and in many cases it goes through resource manager operations. So the correlation engine going through all these alerts and find the correlation, and also the attack story is based on many different alerts that are from different bundles. We mentioned like the cryptocurrency. We have, for example, a good example for the compute resources. We have a specific suspicious ARM alert for deploying many compute resources, but correlating it with DNS alert that notifies the resources that had been created are starting to communicating to a known cryptocurrency domain. This is what make it much easier to the SOC to understand there is a cryptocurrency attack happening. Or another case is we know that sometimes attackers are trying to get information. So they are doing enumeration to key vault in order to find a specific a key to access this sensitive storage accounts. So here too, we have an incident that are for exfiltration attack scenarios, that someone is doing enumeration for a key vault and also is triggering a storage account. This is just the tip of the iceberg of the incidents that we have and how they are across all the bundles.
This is such an important capability, mainly when you start looking at this data correlation across different workloads, because as you said, threat actor can compromise one resource, jump to another, and we are able to do this correlation. So that's very exciting. Let's actually go to the demo now and see an example of an insecure alert.
Of course. Awesome. So here we are in the overview blade in the Microsoft Defender for Cloud. So all these incidents are going to the same security alerts blade. And we will see here, for example, security incident has been detected. We are matching the severity as for every incident based on what we think is the best match for the attack scenario we are trying to represent. And here is one example of an incident that involved Azure Toolkit's activity. So as we all, as we might know, there are many toolkits that attackers are being used for enumerating or running code. Microburst is one of them, and Defender for ARM has different detections to detect those activities. But we can see more than that, that a run command, a suspicious run command script was also detected on the same virtual machine, actually. So we have here two alerts that are sharing the same resource and also the same user. We have the description that is very specifically designed for this incident that gives the SOC operations team a better understanding on what are we triggering on about, what this incident is about. And once we are clicking on the alert, on one of the alerts, we will see all the details about each alert. So for example, we will see here the related entities, the resource, the IP, same as we have would have seen the specific security alert. This what brings a really a better capabilities and better understanding for the security operations on how to investigate and the complete view on what would be the remediation for these malicious activities.
This is awesome. Thank you very much for putting the demo together and going through the details. Any final consideration before we wrap up?
No, I just want to thank you for having me today. I really appreciate it. And I hope the customer will enjoy our new capabilities.
Absolutely, my friend. You're always welcome here. If you create something new, let me know and we'll have you again back to the show.
Okay, I will take a note for that.
All right, everyone. That's a wrap for today's episode. Thank you very much for your audience. I hope to see you next time. Again, make sure to subscribe to our playlist at Microsoft Security Channel on YouTube and stay tuned for more. See you next time.